started with the question, how can one expand the number of students from hundreds to millions? Well, the world is not what it was 2 years ago. So I think this expansion is not as improbable as it may seem. And an important part of the answer is technology. Important, but not the sole element. And I will be repeating some of what Ralph just said. Technology is going to be an integral part of our future education, and it can serve as a very effective tool for delivering quality education that is inclusive. One argument against online learning is the digital divide that makes learning through this medium inaccessible to the majority. Only a third of all the students worldwide had access to online education. But technology is not just smartphones, computers, and the internet. We have more easily accessible and affordable technology, you know, such as the old faithful radio and television. Radio actually covers 75% of the world population. In India, it reaches more than 99% of the people. So we do have what is needed for accessible and inclusive means of disseminating information. What we need is a new pedagogy, one that, you know, incorporates technology and is, you know, relevant today to online teaching and learning. So what about Zoom fatigue? Can real learning happen, you know, sitting in front of a gadget all day? True, replicating the physical class in Zoom is not a long-term method. We adapted to this medium rather recently with little training, preparation, or, you know, advance notice. But then the way we adapted to it, it reminds me a little of how many took to the, you know, cordless telephone decades ago. After being used to a wired telephone for years, some could not move away from a particular place where the cordless or the cellular phone was placed. They were still tied to that place by an imaginary wire. Somewhat like that, we are replicating in the digital medium what we did in the physical classroom. We have not explored a fraction of what the ICT offers. And that brings me to the critical point of teachers' training, which is a very large and important issue in itself. But within this, I would just like to flag 2 points that tie into this topic of ICT as a delivery system. One is that information can now be accessed anywhere at any time from, you know, multiple sources. So now that teachers are no longer needed to disseminate information, they can do what is far more important: sharing knowledge, developing students' personality, imparting values, as Big New pointed out, is very important. The second is the fact that as new knowledge continues to expand, it is no longer possible to compress all that students need to be taught within the limited time span of a course. So this requires educating students with the skills to manage their own learning throughout life. So the flipped method of learning and lifelong learning are going to be aspects of an innovative delivery system of global higher education that harnesses the, you know, power of ICT. And I believe that, you know, striking the right balance between the use of technology and being person-centered is the challenge that we need to, you know, handle creatively. Thank you.